Guess who's back again. Guess who's back. Tell a friend, Hi everyone, this is Necrostevo, and I am finally back to uploading again. I don't know if you all missed me or not. I don't know if you all even noticed that I wasn't uploading, but thank you all so much for your patience and for even watching this video. That means you're still subscribed, or you saw it posted somewhere, decided to check it out. My chair just popped. I think it was my chair. Might have been my knee. Hope it wasn't my hip. I'm not that old. I did turn 26 2 days ago. On the 15th. So that's the thing. But now that I'm back to uploading again, we should be back to our Tuesday-Saturday schedule. What this will entail, I will post an update video on later. But that is later. For now, we have a battle against one of my greatest rivals, Connor. As you can see, the teams are kind of a mishmash. Going into this battle, my goal was to get a Venomoth sweep. I just wanted to do that. And he decided to bring things that pretty much stuff Venomoth pretty easily. So that was going to be a little bit difficult. Now, in addition to Venomoth, of course, mine is a little weird. It has Substitute, Disable, Quiver Dance, and Bug Buzz with the Tinted Lens ability. So it's kind of designed to sub up, see what my opponent's going to do. And then, of course, disable what their move is to hit Venomoth with. And then get free Quiver Dances when they're forced to switch. Skarmory and Mandibuzz make a pretty decent core. Since they're both weak to electricity, I decided to bring Assault Vest Donphan. And then we have Life Orbed Magmortar with Modest Nature to round out kind of the more specially attacking end of this team, because everything here is kind of physical except for Venomoth. And then I brought Mega Tyranitar just because I didn't have a Mega. I wanted to use Noctis, which is the one that I actually got from Renato, I think. So that's going to be my Dragon Dancing Tyranitar in the very cool Pokeball. So kind of some things I had going on there. When I was looking at his team, I knew he didn't have Mega Kangaskhan, so Aragorn's definitely going to be his Mega. Rotom is kind of a pain for this team. I can outspeed and hit it pretty hard with Tyranitar, but then I get hit by Hydro Pump. And of course, it has Thunderbolt to threaten both of my walls, and then it can hit Donphan with the Hydro Pump. So Rotom was going to be a little bit annoying going into this battle, but I decided to start off with Skarmory. This is my max speed, max HP Skarmory instead of a more defensive one. It's designed to kind of be an anti-lead. I really wish I put Rocky Helmet on it for this battle, because that would have come into a lot of help with how much is facing down physical attackers in this battle. I think Connor only went for a Fake Out to see what item I was running right there, because it really didn't do any damage, especially after Leftovers. I'm able to put up my Stealth Rocks, and then I switch out expecting the Flamethrower coming from Goodra, which I do find out that he has. And Connor did a really good job playing with this Goodra early on, because I was definitely fooled into thinking that it was choiced in some manner. I haven't played a lot with Assault Vest Donphan, so it's difficult to tell when things actually are scarfed and or specs, that type of thing. He surprises me by bringing in Aggron that has a choice scarf as I knock it off. That Earthquake of his still did a lot of damage, but I'm able to finish it off. That wasn't his Mega. I was very surprised. Goodra comes back in. Now I'm expecting either a Water-type move or a Grass-type move. He decides to go with Power Whip, and so now I'm definitely thinking Choice Scarf, because he switched out earlier where he could have just gone for the Flamethrower, or, you know, switched up his moves and then gone for the Power Whip then. But he switches out again, so now I'm definitely thinking, oh, well, that confirms it. Basically, it's Scarfed. And knowing that he was going to switch, I went for Knock Off, and I knocked the Sky Plate off of the Honchkrow, which is actually pretty good to see. I don't want to get hit by Brave Birds off of that base attack stat with a possible Moxie ability and a Sky Plate. Don't want to deal with that. Unfortunately, I do miss Toxic, which actually does come up a little bit later. It doesn't make that big of a deal now, but the amount of damage he would have accumulated through Toxic is pretty significant. I knew he had Scolipede, and that was a pretty easy switch in, so I just went for Whirlwind expecting the switch, and he does switch in Scolipede. I'm able to get a little bit of free Stealth Rock damage on it. Unfortunately, I did Whirlwind him out into Rotom, and expecting him to Volt Switch, I stayed in, but he just went for Thunderbolt, and that hurt. That hit over half of my HP. This is my weird Manibuzz that I bred in 5th gen, so it kind of has a strange EV spread, but we can see it working out pretty well here, as I'm able to take the Hydro Pump. I stayed in with Manibuzz and Roosted because the switch back to Donphan or to Tyranitar to take the Volt Switch was pretty obvious. And so I figured I could take a Hydro Pump because I took the super effect of Thunderbolt that well. I am able to Roost up. He does end up Volt Switching out now, so I'm happy I stayed in. I just continue to go for knockoff. I was able to get rid of the Rotom's leftovers, and now I'm able to poison the Kangaskhan, which is really good because Kangaskhan is actually quite bulky even without going into its Mega Form. Now here I was expecting Fake Out again. He actually just goes straight for Double Edge, probably expecting Excalibur to come in. Between the recoil and the poison, I thought it was fairly obvious that all he needed to do was switch out into Rotom. That or he might expect my Whirlwind, and so I decided to switch, thinking, oh, he's going to switch out. And I switch into Donphan, but he actually just goes straight for Drain Punch, which kind of sucks. I could have just stayed in with Excalibur and attacked him, or gone for Whirlwind. Drain Punch would not have done very much. So overprediction kind of cost me my Donphan here. I'm able to hit him with Ice Shard, but as I said, this is an Assault Vest variant. Max HP, max Special Defense. I believe I also got that one from Renato. Granted, I went through and caught a bunch of things in Heart Gold, Soul Silver for both of us so that he could have things to breed him in cool Pokeballs. So definitely big shout outs to him. Now, I did see this as a good opportunity to go out into Venomoth, but he brings out Honchkrow, and I don't want to get hit by a Brave Bird because Honchkrow will most likely outspeed. I have a weird EV spread on my Venomoth, so I didn't want to chance that. Venomoth actually has a pretty nice speed stat even before Quiver Dancing. All that aside, though, I'm going to be in a position where we're kind of just both healing up our flying types. He needs Honchkrow in order to possibly take up my Tyranitar with Steel Wing, and of course to hit Venomoth with Brave Bird or Sucker Punch if I get too fast. And I need my Skarmory for everything but his Goodra, basically. So Goodra's actually going to come out now. I didn't predict that. I just felt like it was time to switch. And here I'm afraid of the Power Whip once again. I go out into Magmortar. Without Stealth Rocks up, it's going to be pretty easy to switch him around. The Sandstream is not ideal, though, so kind of have to play a little bit of Hit and Run because I do have Life Orb on Magmortar. I knew there was a good possibility that he would bring in Rotom here, but I just went for the Hidden Power Ice anyway. Again, I was still thinking that he was Choice Scarfed. So if he wanted to go out into his Honchkrow, then Hidden Power Ice would have been the optimal play there. And also, I'm not really that afraid of Rotom anymore, now that I've whittled out his HP a good bit and it no longer has access to leftovers. Now was a fantastic time to just bring out Venomoth, because I'm going to be able to take down Rotom, which is very, very nice. I think that's the first time Mothra has actually ever gotten a kill. I bred this back in 5th gen. And now I need to see if he's going to lock himself into Flamethrower, and then I can disable it. But he actually goes for Dragon Pulse, which I thought was a little bit weird. But thinking that he was choiced, I was like, no big deal. I can just Quiver Dance up here, take it pretty comfortably, and then disable it. So he goes for another Dragon Pulse, and this does way more damage than I intended it to. I barely survive it. And that's okay, though. I'm able to disable, and he's not going to be able to attack me. And now we're in a great position, because now he's going to switch out, right? Right? No, he stays in and uses Struggle, completely stifling any idea I had for a sweep of Venomoth proportions. So that was actually a pretty good play on his part, just staying in and going for Struggle. If he had switched out, probably would have swept his whole team. But neither here nor there. I bring out Magmortar as he goes into Honchkrow. I don't want to take a possible Sucker Punch, and so I switch back into the Tyranitar. I know that now Honchkrow carries Steel Wing just for Tyranitar, and also for Fairy types, just because of how popular they are now. Not really that concerned about it, though, although this is a max speed, max attack Tyranitar. Still going to take it after I Mega Evolve. I missed the first Stone Edge. It's a little bit annoying there. He even gets a defense boost, but I'm able to KO him through it. If I had had all that wonderful toxic damage on him from earlier, It may not have mattered because he roosted, but he also may not have been in a position to where he would have been able to live a crunch or something like that. I don't know. So I'm able to finish off the Scallopede with one final crunch, and that's going to be the end of that battle. Unexpectedly close, since I was just down to Tyranitar and Magmortar. But still a fun battle. That's the most important thing. Now, I want to start my schedule up again next week. Somewhere in there, I'm going to have an update video kind of explaining where I've been. For those of you all who are curious, some of you may not be curious. That's okay. It's always just good to put those little bookmarks in each chapter. I am playing Final Fantasy X HD, so listen to my story. This may be our last chance. Yeah.